Now we will work in this opening, yes? So we will put one arm back. Try to again lengthen the spine. With the other arm, we try to help this arm without pushing, without forcing too much. We put the arm back. With this arm, we try to help to bring that arm a little bit more on the back of the head, expanding your spine. So lengthen the spine, lengthen the side, open your shoulder blade, lifting your head, lengthen your neck. We try to stretch there. And then if we can, we bring the other arm back, yes? So you will see this position on the back, yes? If you feel, we can take the fingers. If not, don't worry, just put the hands there, yes? So breathing in, again, grounding your sit bones, lengthen your spine, open your chest. Maintaining the breathing, trying to relax the shoulders at the same time. Don't squeeze the shoulders, yes? Relax the shoulder, lengthen the spine and your neck, and then relax, release. When you do these kind of positions, normally you feel awful as you do the pose, but when you relax, you will feel a nice relief on the shoulders and the neck. So we bring the other arm. Again, lengthen the spine, lengthen the head up, the neck. Try to relax this arm back. Open, try to open the side. Bring the arm back. And then again, we release this arm, relax the shoulder, put the arm again back. Remember, trying to look for the fingers, but don't worry if you don't take the fingers, just put the hands wherever you arrive. Lengthen, expand, open. And try to relax the shoulders as you breathe out. Good, and then relax. Well done, good. Now, from here, we will use another chair. We will put the chair on the front. So you can do this with two chairs, or you can use your chair and your desk, okay? So we put the chair on the front, or having the desk there. Move the keyboard a little bit away from you. Open the legs, try to lengthen the spine. Put the hands on the chair or on the desk, yeah? And slowly try to flex from the hips. Don't round the back, yes? Lengthen the spine, chest open. We go slowly forward. We put the hands on the chair. Expanding your spine, your shoulders away, your chest open. And then slowly we release. It's like we try to put the belly between the legs and the chest. And then we put the arms, if you are by the elbows, and we try to relax in this position. Your legs comfortable open, to allow your belly and your chest to be between the legs. And simply relax, using your breathing. So when you breathe in, lengthen your spine. When you breathe out, relax. And again, breathing in, open, expand. Breathing out, relax. And we can stay here for a few breathings, relaxing, stretching your back, relaxing your shoulder blades, your armpits, your elbows, your head. This position brings a lot of relief to the lower back, act as a counterbalance for your spine, because it stretches your spine from the hips to the crown of the head, and also bring relief to your hips. Good. And then release. Good. Now, we take the chair again. Yes. And we use the same position without the chair. So it will be a little bit deeper. So again, hips, knees open. Imagine that you want to make a sandwich between your body and your legs. So go slowly, open the chest, shoulders back, opening the chest, belly between the legs, chest open, maintain your spine, open, open, open. And then releasing slowly with your hands, wherever you are right, and release. Relax. This position is also good to bring circulation to the brain. So sometimes when you are too tired, you can use this position to refresh the brain. Yes? And then when you go up slowly, you will feel more relaxed on the head and maybe with new ideas. So release completely.
Always using your breathing really deeply. Allow the breathing to open your chest, your belly. When you breathe out, surrender to the floor. Let go. Now, take your feet or your toes or your legs, wherever you are right. Breathing in, lengthen your spine. Open, open your chest. Lifting the head. Breathing out, release again. And we do one more. Breathing in, open your chest, lifting, lengthen. Breathe out, release. Good. So you can do it a few times. To go up, we go slowly, using your hands as a support. Now we round the back. We try to put the sit bones again on the chair, and then slowly, slowly, we open. And we expand, shoulders away. Breathing deeply. Good. Now we will stand it up, and I will show two exercises that we can do on the desk or on the chair, yes? We will put the chair in front, yes? And we will take the hands on the chair, okay? Start closer. Take the chair. Try to lengthen your spine. Again, open your chest. Relax the shoulders, yes? Lengthen. And try to open your chest, your spine. Belly in, and try to go with your hips forward without sticking the belly out. Okay, so maintaining this strong to support the lower back and the spine. And we bring the hips forward, opening the spine. We try to relax the shoulder blades, the shoulders back, and we stay in this position. Opening, breathing deeply. So this position again will act as a counterbalance for the position that you have all the time rounding on the computer. Yes, so even a few a day of this will help to feel more comfortable in your body and less stress, less tired. Good. And then the last one that I want to show you today, we put the hands on the chair, feet parallels, yes? Bending the knees, always bend the knees to protect the lower back. We relax the chest, relax the shoulders, and we try to breathe out and relax your body down. So letting go completely. Maintain your knees bending to support again the lower back, to don't work so hard on the hamstrings, and release. Also here, be aware of your shoulders, always the shoulders away from your ears. And if you can, try to lengthen your spine. Imagine that you want to bring the hips back as much as you can to lengthen your spine, and then relax the shoulders, relax the head. Shoulders again, always away from your body. And maintain this position, breathing deeply. To come back, we can go slowly rounding your back. We walk forward. And breathing in, expand. Good. And I show you the last one. I say the last one before, but this is the last one. We put the arm on the wall, if you have a wall around. Put the fingers facing back. And put the hand on the wall and try to expand this angle here between the shoulder and the arm and the chest. With the shoulder relaxed, okay? So try to maintain the shoulder down. Don't bring the shoulder to your ear. When you do this position, probably you will feel some tingling in the fingers. That's normal, okay? This is really good to open the shoulder, to relax the position. Good. And then we do the same to the opposite side. Fingers back. And expand. Try to maintain your body really long, straight, open. Don't force, always. Be comfortable in your body. Don't push your body so much. Expand. This helps also to relieve the tension for the arm all the time on the mouse and the hand and the fingers. Yes. So even if you can do this one only, that will be great. Good. And then we're done. So now I will meet you in the next part of the video. See you later.